In the last week or so, we've started being able to get access to the fire impacted areas. We're seeing what's happening on the ground, and there is large scale impact. The fire has been very severe in lots of areas, but there are areas where nature has survived, and that's where our focus is really turning. Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Norman. I'm the Chief Conservation Scientist at Parks Victoria, and I'm one of a large group of people that are looking at the impacts of nature and fire across Victoria. So it's only in the last week or so that we've been able to get into some of these fire affected areas, and recently we did a reconnaissance flight across all of eastern Victoria, and we chose 18 sites of really key importance for wildlife, for threatened species, for threatened habitats, and we flew over and took footage and information on how those areas are faring. From the flights we've recently done, we're finding there's really sobering impacts, really high intensity fires in some areas. In other areas, there are large patches of green on the landscape, and we're really pleased that some areas have remained unscathed at this stage, and they're becoming the real focus of our attention.
My name's James Todd. I'm the Executive Director of Biodiversity in the Department of Environment, Land, Water and Planning. We've been working with project partners and portfolio agencies like Parks Victoria, as well as subject matter experts and independent scientists. We've come up with a plan, which is about identifying the shorter term actions and the longer term actions that we need to recover biodiversity in Victoria. On the back of that, the Victorian Government has allocated $17.5 million for emergency actions over the next 6 months to support that recovery.
The scale of this and the impacts on our forested areas of eastern Victoria is really unprecedented. We're moving into new times and new circumstances because of climate change and its impacts. So this is not a normal bushfire, it's beyond that. Probably the most sobering was the intensity of the fire around areas like Goongara and Martin's Creek. So in these areas, the fire was so intense that you could see the streaking up the hills from the fire tornadoes sucking the ash up. So these are very high intensity fires, and these will have long-term impacts. In many ways, we weren't expecting the worst. The footprint is so large, it looked like everything had been wiped out, and that's not the case. We came across lots of green forest intact within waterways on burnt landscapes. So the moisture areas, those temperate rainforests where trees like lily pillies remained and were moist enough not to burn, there's these green corridors along the waterways that have survived. And in some places, they were really quite large areas. So approaching Mount Ellery in Erinundra National Park, we went over lots of burnt areas, but then we came across an entire area of tree ferns and ancient Gondwanan tree sassafras, their cone-shaped trees in amongst these landscapes. And there was a really large area there of intact, healthy rainforest. We went looking for and hoping for the survival of the brush-tailed rock wallaby population in Little River Gorge, which is in the Snowy River National Park. And we were absolutely delighted to come over a burnt ridge and find the entire gorge is still fully green, full of vegetation, full of water, clean water running down the middle, waterfalls running out of the rock faces. And we were so relieved to know that the stronghold for brush-tailed rock wallabies in Victoria is still intact.
We know that fires burn patchily. In some parts of the landscape, they burn very hot. In other cases, they may not burn at all. The sort of information that we're getting through the aerial surveys will help us, one, understand the relative impacts, and two, help us target the actions to the things that are going to have the best outcomes. Fair to say that recovery may take a long time, and for some of these landscapes, they may change forever.